Navagraha are the nine heavenly bodies and deities that influence human life on earth according to Hinduism and Hindu astrology. This video will narrate to you the various aspects and stories associated with the second of the Navagraha, Chandra. To know more about the other planets of the Navagraha, watch the playlist linked in the comments below. Chandra, also known as Soma, is the Hindu god of the moon and is associated with the night, plants and vegetation. The second day of the week, Monday, is dedicated to this god and is known as Somvar in Hindi. One must offer white or silver colored articles and wear white to please the celestial god. Chandra is depicted only with a face and has two hands holding white lotuses but no body. The lunar deity is never depicted with a full body, symbolizing his waxing and waning. There are multiple stories behind the birth of Chandradev. In the first version, Chandra was born in the ocean of milk and nearly blinded the Devas with his bright, glowing body. The Devas unanimously decided to give Chandra the status of a planet and sent him to the cosmos. The second version goes as follows. Lord Brahma began creating the universe. As he created the seven rishis, he instructed them to aid him in his creation by engaging in procreation. The seven rishis were Vashishtha, Marichi, Pulastya, Pulaha, Atri, Angiras, and Kratu. Atri was married to Anusuya and had no children. Anusuya was a very virtuous woman. So the Trinity, Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva wanted to test Anusuya. They transformed themselves into three sages and appeared before Atri and Anusuya, asking them to serve food. They were welcomed into the house and the Trinity said that they follow some principles and only if the food is served adhering to those principles, they would accept it. The Trinity said that they wanted to see Anusuya naked and then she could serve them food. Atri was shocked to hear this. Anusuya immediately agreed and transformed the Trinity into infants and began feeding them naked. Sage Narada learns about this and informs the three Devis, Parvati, Lakshmi and Saraswati. The Devis come to meet Anusuya and request her to release their consorts from infancy and give them back their divine Trinity form. Anusuya agrees to this request and the Trinity now appear as Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva. All the gods, pleased with Anusuya's virtuousness, offer them a boon, to which the couple ask for a son who will be remembered forever by Mother Earth and who will prove useful to human and other forms of life. Thus were born the three sons, Chandra, Durvasa and Dattatreya. Chandra was married to the 27 daughters of Daksha, the son of Lord Brahma. Those 27 daughters are the 27 lunar asterisms or stars. When Daksha gave away his 27 daughters in marriage to Chandra, he asked for a promise from Chandra that he would never look down upon any of his daughters and would treat them all equally with love and care. Chandra too promised Daksha that he will love and care all his wives equally. But amongst all his 27 wives, Chandra was the most fond of his fourth wife, Rohini, and spent most of his time with her. The other 26 wives were unhappy with this. They went to their father and complained about this. By listening to the complaints of Chandradev from his daughters, Daksha got angry. In his anger, Daksha cursed his son-in-law that all his powers will decline with each passing day, and he would lose his beauty while suffering from a disease named Kshayarog. Chandra begged Daksha to take the curse back, but it was too late. The dying deity prayed to Lord Shiva, who blessed the moon god with a boon, which in a way balanced the effects of the curse. This established the waxing and waning of the moon, according to which the moon increases in brightness for 15 days in Shukla Paksh and decreases in brightness for 15 days in Krishna Paksh. Chandra was disappointed at the thought of waxing and waning. His crescent shape would just be a constant reminder of the curse and his reduced strength. Shiva consoled him by saying that the crescent indicates that he would still retain some of his powers. Shiva also proposed to wear the crescent moon on his hair to show his devotees that they are dear to him even in their lowest moments. Thus, Shiva came to be known as Chandrasekhara, meaning the one with Chandra mounted on his head. Due to this curse of Daksha, the moon does not have children from his 27 wives. However, before his marriage, Chandra fathered the planet Buddha or Mercury with Tara, the wife of Brihaspati, who is the guru of the Devas. As per this story, once Chandra decided to perform the greatest of yagyas, Rajasuya Yagya. Chandra requested the guru of the Devas, Brihaspati, to preside as the main priest to perform the yagya. Due to some other reason, Brihaspati could not go and asked his wife Tara to preside over the yagya instead. As the yagya was progressing, Chandra began to attain a more beautiful form. His divine beauty kept increasing to such an extent that all the apsaras, including Devaguru's wife Tara, began to fall for Chandra's beauty. Tara returned home pregnant and everybody questioned whose child was in her womb. Tara revealed that the child in her womb is of Chandra, the moon god. Listening to this sentence, Brihaspati was infuriated and cursed the child that he will become an androgynous being. Therefore, Mercury or Buddha is neither considered a male nor a female.